sun rises over the mist-laden mountains, we see for the first time the beautiful panorama of the fabulous city of Hollywood, mecca of the motion picture industry. With its myriad of homes dotted hither and yon in the hilltops, its busy thoroughfares, its happy throngs of gay-hearted citizens rushing here and there. And in the dancing sunbeams, we notice the architectural splendor of Hollywood that befits such a glamorous metropolis. Yes, even the buildings have a personality all their own, as witness the oriental magnitude of the Chinese theater, with its pagodas and gracious figurines bedecking the contour of the structure. Hollywood Broadcasting Studios, where millions of Americans listen nightly to the star-studded programs that emanate from these modernistic radio emporiums. And the Temple of Art, the Earl Carroll Theatre, with its famous slogan, "Through these portals pass the most beautiful girls in the world." And another theatre of mirth, the El Capitan Theatre, with its scintillating array of stars, presented by that ace comedian, Ken Murray. Yes, there's lots to see and do in this wonderful city of Hollywood, a magnet drawing thousands upon thousands of people from all walks of life to a particular cross-section of humanity. An endless movement of rhythmic feet towards the center of the world, Hollywood and Vine.
Extra, extra, read all about it. Martin Murray throws Hollywood party. Extra, read all about it. Martin Murray throws Hollywood party.
Idea. I'm waiting to go to Martin Murray's birthday party.
Why are you dressed like that?
Can you tell me how to get to Martin Murray's house?
Oh, you must be going to his birthday party.
Yeah, I hate to go.
Well, then why are you going?
Oh, I had a fight with my boyfriend and I want to suffer. Ginny, where are those two guys we have dates with? Oh, here they come now.
Hello, girls. I brought my friend along, just like I promised.
My sister says she won't go out until she hears him talk.
Okay, sister, let's have it. Give me everything you've got.
Sure, I'd be glad to.
I mean your money.
My money? How dare you?
Come on, or I'll shoot.
Please don't shoot. I'll do anything you say.
Anything?
Yes, anything.
All right, will you go to Martin Murray's birthday party with me?
Is that where you're going?
Yeah.
Go ahead, shoot.
Operator's license.
A judge wouldn't give me one.
Wouldn't give you one, eh? How'd you like to come along to the station house with me?
Oh, no, thanks. You're not my type. And besides, I'm going to Martin Murray's birthday party. Say, you look like a nice fella. Here's a ticket to the party. You'll be there this afternoon at 5 o'clock.
Well, say, that's mighty nice. I really like that. Here's a ticket for you. You'll be in traffic court at 9 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Right now, we have a real treat for you. I want you to meet a little lady from Earl Carroll's. She's a pretty little skate and a pretty little skater. The one and only Jeannie Ritchie.
Thank you. sing, I don't dance, and I don't tell funny stories. All I got is talent.
Would you like to make some money?
Sure, I'd love it.
Would you like to make $100?
$100? How?
I'd bet you $100 that you're not here.
Let me get this straight. You're going to bet me $100 that I'm not here?
That's right. I bet you $100 you're not here.
$100 I ever got. You know, you're crazy, you know. Put it up.
All right, there's $100.
And I'm not here.
That's right. Would you like to make more than $100?
You want to bet me more?
That's right.
Same thing?
Same thing.
Not here?
Not here.
Put it up.
That's $200.
Right. Prove it to me that I'm not here.
You're not in Chicago, are you?
No.
You're not in Detroit, are you?
No.
You're not in New York, are you?
No.
Well, if you're not in Chicago, you're not in Detroit, and you're not in New York, you must be someplace else.
That's right.
Well, if you must be someplace else, you're not here.
Well, he rooked me somewhere. Well, I'll try working on somebody else. It must be somebody that's dumber than I. Ah! Hello, Billy.
Hiya, Shovel Schnoz.
Don't ad-libby, please. Well, what do you want? Would you like to make some money?
I'd love to make some money. How?
$100?
$100? What doing?
I'll bet you $100 that you're not here.
Gonna bet me $100 that I'm not here?
$100 you're not here.
It's a bet.
$100.
$100 for me, boy.
Like but
I'm
more?
Not here, eh?
That's right. Like Mr. Moore?
Anything you say.
Another $100.
$100. Okay.
Who put this 50 in here?
Now, hold it. Prove it to me.
All right. You're not in Chicago, are you?
Not in Chicago.
You're not in Detroit, are you?
Not in Detroit. I'm gonna get him.
You're not in New York, are you?
I'm not in New York.
You're not in Chicago, not Detroit, not New York.
Mm-hmm.
You gotta be someplace else.
That's right.
You're someplace else, you can't be here.
That's right. That's right.
Wait a minute. You lost. Put that money down.
What do you mean, put what money down?
The money you just picked up there. You lost that.
What money are you talking about?
The money we bet you just picked up. You lost.
Don't give me that.
Wait a minute. Come over here.
Look here. Look here. Just a minute. Droopsnoot. I'm not in Chicago?
No.
I'm not in Detroit? I'm not in New York?
No.
Well, if I'm not in Chicago, not in Detroit, not in New York, it must be some other place, right?
That's right.
If I'm in some other place, I can't be here.
No.
If I'm not here, I couldn't take your money. Bumper.
And now, folks, I would like to introduce two charming exponents of the Terpsichorean art. They're both in their fifth month at Ken Murray's Blackouts, the lovely Roma twins.
Everyone. Let's go in the house and find out.
It's been a wonderful party, hasn't it?
Terrific party.
Whatever became of that beautiful wife of yours? Where is she?
Pat?
Pat, yeah, where
she's over here somewhere.
Bring her on.
Let's get her to sing a song. Pat! Come over here, honey. I called you over here because I want you to sing a song with Harry.
Billy Meyer, it's a lovely ring you have there. You
haven't seen it before?
Where'd you get it?
My fairy godmother gave it to me.
Your fairy godmother?
Mm-hmm. Haven't you got a fairy godmother?
No, but I've got an uncle, and since Harry's here, I'd like to sing one of his songs.
Well, he's written so many of his. Did you ever see A Dream Walking? Stay as Sweet as You
Stay
Are.
Stay as Sweet as You Are.
That's the one. Okay, Harry.
Stay as sweet as you are. Don't let a thing ever change you.
you. Don't ever lose all the charm you possess. Your loveliness, darling, the way you say yes. Stay as sweet as you are, discreet as you are, you're divine, dear. Stay as grand as you are, and as you are, tell me that you're mine, dear. Young and gay or old and gray, near to me or afar, night and day I pray that you'll always stay.
Oh, you look lovely tonight, especially in that gown.
Oh, gee. Oh, it's just a little thing I picked up to peel potatoes in.
I beg your pardon?
Little thing I picked up to peel potatoes in.
Uh-huh. Call me Spud.
Oh.
Well, that dress really brings out your eyes.
Brings out yours, too.
I understand. Look, Marie, I think the people here would like to know a few things about you. Where were you born, for instance?
Well, I was born in Anaheim.
Anaheim, huh?
It's a place.
Yes, I understand.
California's all around it.
Oh, yeah.
I was born in a grapefruit grove.
What?
Born in a grapefruit grove.
That explains a couple of things. Gee, I feel good tonight, though. I mean,
gee, you look wonderful. You know, you're so healthy and so full of them.
Yeah, I think so. You know, you look really healthy, and what would you folks do in a case like this?
Well, well, thanks a lot.
See you later, huh?
Bye.
And now, gang, I want you to meet a young lady whose singing and talents has made her one of the outstanding personalities in Hollywood. In fact, she has beauty. She has a face that producers go for, face the cameraman gopher, director's gopher. So may I present gopher face Lynn Ashley. Here she is, coming out, Lynn. Now, Lynn, I got you up here. I want you to sing a little song for us, but you think you can sing? Are you sober?
Oh, sober? What do you mean, sober? Of course I am. I haven't been drinking half as much as I should be.
Oh, you haven't, eh?
No.
How come?
I cut out the chasers.
Who writes your material?
You
Go
don't.
Ahead and sing.
Okay.
Introducing now for your pleasure a new song written for the picture by Harry Revel, one of Hollywood's outstanding composers, and sung by a new scintillating chanteuse, a delineator of popular songs, star of the National Broadcasting Company, Miss Linda Stevens.
Linda.
Love is a temporary thing. It doesn't last forever. Love is a sentimental fling that brings two hearts together. Just when you're certain you found a love that will last, down car future is strictly a past. Love is a trip to paradise That much I know is cricket. And you'll be careful if you're wise and buy a two-way ticket. Yet who am I to vilify the wonders of Cupid and spring? Well, I'm just a lucky fool, exception to prove the rule that love is a temporary thing. Love is a trip to paradise, that much I know is cricket. And you'll be careful if you're wise and get a two-way ticket. Yet who am I to vilify the wonders of Cupid and spring? Well, I'm just a lucky fool, exception to prove the rule that love is a temporary thing.
Ladies and gentlemen, now that the critics have previewed this wonderful picture, we have something special for Martin Murray. Martin, come here. Martin, you've done a wonderful job.
Thank you.
And the critics feel that you're entitled to an Academy Award.
Me?
Yes,
an Academy Award?
Yes. The Acme Writing Academy.
Oh. Read all about it. Hollywood Party throws Martin Murray. Read all about it. Get your paper here. Hollywood Party throws Martin Murray. Read all about it.
Well, folks, we told you anything could happen in Hollywood, and it did. As we reluctantly say farewell to this fabulous city of make-believe, we notice once again that busy thoroughfare, Hollywood Boulevard, with its teeming thousands of rhythmic feet homeward bound. A veritable maelstrom of happy humanity through with their chores for the day. Yes, night will fall as it invariably must. Celestial stars will smile down upon the motion picture luminaries, and dusk will envelop the most glamorous city in the world, Hollywood.